So, except as otherwise specifically provided, imported merchandise shall be appraised for the purpose of charter on the basis of the following. Transaction value, right? So, the assessment goes on the transaction value. All right, so what's the transaction value, right? Transaction value, as we go down, is the price actually paid or payable. Price actually paid. Payable. All right. So what does it mean? What does it mean to have a price actually paid or payable? So you have all those inclusions. But if you scroll down the paragraph, subparagraph 4. Okay, for the purposes of this subsection, price actually paid or payable means the total payment, whether direct or indirect, and exclusive. Okay, here's the thing. Exclusive of any cost, charges, expenses incurred for transportation. So no duties or no MPF for that matter, no MPF for transportation and insurance. And related services, such as customs brokerage fees, for example, incident to international shipment of merchandise. So if you're having the ocean freight charges, there is no MPF. Those charges are non-dutiable charges, and they also, by definition, they are not included in MPF. So going back to our, and this rhetoric can be found, so I'm using this 19 U.S.C. 1401A because it was found in the regulatory text, right? So this is the conclusions we went through, right? But because our studying is based on the Code of Federal Regulations, we can find the very same thing in the Valuation and Appraisement of Merchandise chapter. Right, classification and appraisement of merchandise. So if we go down to the one part 152, we will find the same language in 153.03 transaction value. So transaction value is price actually paid or payable, and the definition of price actually paid or payable is provided in 152.102, which talks about the price actually paid or payable as, and you can see it's kind of like copied and pasted from this particular law, which says that it does not include exclusive of any charges, costs, or expenses incurred in transportation, insurance, and related services. Of course, transaction value is one way of appraising. There is also transaction, if that doesn't work, you use transaction value of the identical merchandise, then you go to the deductive value, computed value, and you can switch those as your basis of appraisement. But here, the default is transaction value. So why are we talking about this? Because when we go back, if we go back and read carefully the answer, the fact pattern, we see that non-dutiable charges, NDPs, and non-dutiable charges are those exclusions such as transportation, international transportation, such as the ocean freight, and insurance costs and the broker charges, which are not part. So if you are not paying the $2,500, so your default rule should be that if you are not using $2,500 as a part of your calculation, then you should be using the total entered value, because this is the assessment on the MPF, not this one. However, there is a caveat. There is a caveat because CBP examiners, generally speaking, the non-dutiable charges claim cannot be supported through if NDC, non-dutiable charges, cannot be supported through the documentation, CBP reserves the right to assess MPF on NDC. CBP examiners have applied this NDC, non-dutiable charges, to MPF in the past, and this is one example where customs examiners provide you with a line item breakdown, but they use the merchandise processing fee assessment based on not on 185, as it should be, provided that all the documentation is correct, but on 187.50. This is, so usually my starting point would be 185, because I know the MPF transaction is based on 1401A, which is further based on 152.103 and 152.102 of the Code of Federal Regulations. However, here, customs examiners decided to not use NDC, to actually use the non-dutiable charges as a part of inclusion of calculation for the merchandise processing fee. So this is the first warning. So what we are going to do, since with the benefit of hindsight, what we're going to do is we're going to use this particular invoice value as the method of calculation for MPF, keeping in mind that given all things equal, this is appropriate method of appraising, provided that you have all the documentation, pursuant to 19 U.S.C. 1401A and its sister provisions in the Code of Federal Regulations, 152.102, section 102, and 152, section 103. All right. So having said that, let's do some math. Let's do some mathematics. So let me raise this. So first thing, step number one is to find out which value we're going to use. Here, customs examiner suggested that you include this, although I say you should not, and we will see if it's going to take longer, but we will see how we can kind of get a sneak preview of what customs are accepting. First of all, we need to establish methodology, right? So methodology is this. You take either this or this as the first thing. So we had a choice, 187,500 or 185,185,000. All right. So we're picking this one with the benefit of hindsight. Next, once you pick that, you have to see how much of the overall invoice value amounted to the export. So 200 bicycles times times $200 equals 40,000. So that's the amount of export that took place. So you can claim your drawback on $40,000. The next thing would be to see how much of this particular 40,000, what is the proportion of, or in other words, or what is the share, overall share of that 187,500 pi is represented by $40,000. So what you do is you draw up a proportion. So you know that 187,500 is 100%. So your goal is to find out how much is 40,000. What is the percentage for 40,000, right? This is your question mark. And the way to do that is easy. You cross multiply. So you multiply this and then you divide by this, all right? So you 40,000 multiplied by 100 and divided by 187,500. And the amount, the appropriate amount here would be 21.3333%. Now, of course, it would be like 3333333. What I suggest here is to limit to 4 digits, and the reason is because unlike many other rounding situations, here you have a small margin for error because see the difference between A and B is just over a dollar. So you are really within a sense category range. So you may wanna be a little bit more conservative when you're rounding the fractions. So now you just established what your percentage is. So the next thing is to see how much of the MPF is being really assessed. So first of all, you have to figure out, was it the 0.3463464, or was the ceiling figure being used? That is done by saying, all right, so if 0.3464% is applicable when we apply this to this amount, what would be the rate that we get, all right? So in other words, what would be the one without cap, what would be the amount, or with a cap, all right? So what we do here is we take 187,500, and we multiply it by 0.003464%. So 187,500 times 0.003464, it would be 649.5. All right, so you have 649.5, which is more than 485. So you cannot go above 485. So you are not taking this amount. This is the amount if you were taking the ad valorem, but you cannot go above 485. So what you do is you kind of say, okay, if you cannot go to 485, you'd access the maximum, $485. So it is not the ad valorem, but it would be the ceiling, right? 485. Remember, bottom is 25, then you use the ad valorem, and as long as it doesn't exceed 485. And if it does exceed, as in this case, then you go with 485, period. So 485 is the appropriate amount. So next step, remember, it's 99% of duties and fees, right? So it will be 99% of the fee itself. So you know that 485 is 100% of the fee. So the question it will be, what will be 99% of the 485? And if you plug in the numbers, you should get $480.15. And no rounding is necessary, I believe, over here. So you multiply 99 by 485, you multiply, and then you divide it by 100. This is how you get this number. All right, so now we have the appropriate amount of total merchandise processing fee that is claimable under the duty provision. And we also know how much of the total duties and fees we need to claim. All right, so now what we do is we go to the last step, and we know that this is 100%, we cannot get more than that as far as merchandise processing fee is concerned. So $480.15 is the maximum, it's 100% of the MPF that we can get provide under this type of invoice value. We also know that what we are looking for is 22. What we are concerned is this amount, because this amount represents that amount, that many, the $40,000, which is comes out of export of 200 bicycles, right? So we're only interested in claiming 21.3333%. And this is a rounded figure. So we do the same thing as we did here. We cross multiply and then we divide by 100. So $480.15 times 21.333 divided by 100, and it should come out to 100. And again, you do the rounding, $102.43. So this is the amount of merchandise processing fee that you can claim back for $40,000. The correct answer is 102.43, and this has been tested on October 2015 exam. Let's go in and double check. Customs CBP, they post exams on this link. And if we go to October 2015 exam, we scroll down to question 52, we'll find out, we will see that same question. Oops, right here. So question 52, 200 bikes were exported, and 102.43 is the correct amount, and we know this because customs examiners also, in addition to all other things, they do provide you with the answer key. And answer key for question 52, oops, let me see, let me close this one down. The answer key for question 52 is B, citing 199.51 B2 4.